outside lifts and stairs. Of course, as designers, we wanted to have outside lifts and stairs, but we managed to justify the cost more than the cost, with two or three times the cost, from the fact that the planning authorities allowed the lifts and stairs not to count as part of the GFA. So the net lettable area inside, which is in the most expensive part of the City of London, was fully revenue producing and more than paid for the cost. So again, this is where additional money opens and makes money for the owner. This is my own apartment in London, which is in a complex called Montevetra, and I just take one piece from this just to go from the very large to the very small, a glass staircase. Of course, a glass staircase on three floors is more expensive than anything else. So it cost something like 600,000 yuan. But when I sold it, the selling agent said the glass staircase, because it let light through into this 14-meter deep building, actually added four times the cost if it had been a solid stair.
In terms of working in China today, trying to convince client to spend more money on something, no matter how you convince them that there will be return, people just don't do it. Do you ever face a problem like that in your practice?
Of course. The design process, certainly in architecture and in product design, is an interaction with the consumer, with the user, with the hotel owner or the office building owner, and whether they buy your argument or not is crucial, of course. You are saying the reality of the situation in China or in Asia is the clients don't want to pay more to get more. But actually, I would say that the real importance of design is its ability to transcend what you might call reality and create a new reality, just like a piece of literature or a poem can transcend reality, take you to another place, and open up something else.